little bit closer.
Right knee, round your back. Inhale to reach up.
As you inhale, you look to the top of your mat, step or jump between your hands. chair pose. Move your knees back. And hexing down, knees with them together. And palms to stand up. Chair pose again. Bend your knees. Move your knees back. Tuck your tongue under. And raise your arms for three. Knees with them together. Thighs running up for two. Four engaged. One. Hands down, right foot steps back. High ground, you're gonna come. Keep a space between your left thigh and your left belly, one inch off. Kick through your right heel. Left knee is right above your left ankle. Kick through your right heel. Come on, your fingertips. Keep a space between your left thigh and your left belly. And arms reach back, but chest lifted. Roll your shoulders back. Lunge pose for three. Keep your right heel back, bring your hips down for two. Strong legs. One. Palms down. Left foot steps back. Come forward to high plank. High plank again. Tuck your tummy under. Squeeze your inner thighs together. Push those palms. Do it again. Squeeze your inner thighs together. Tuck your tummy under. Push those palms and look over. Knees down. Chest comes between your palms. Look forward, arch your lower back. From here, you have an option to stay as it is, or you can also walk your fingers tip to the front, and also rest your elbows down, or if you want more active rhythm, you can come on your fingertips by lifting your elbows for three, two, one. Hands by your chest. You're going to slide your cobra. In your cobra pose, your hips are still pressing it down. Cobra pose, bend your elbow by your ribcage, only 90 degrees up. Chest comes forward. Heart is pushing to the front. Stay there. Hips down. Elbows are bent in your cobra. For three, two, heart pushes forward. Pull your hands to your head. One downward dog. backward bend in here. Chest down, chin down, elbow tucking by your rib cage. If you want, you can also lift your knees off, but keep pressing your upper body to receive the upper back. Left knee. option as before, or if you have the line, you go around. I'll just turn around for your view. You will go around your right foot and grab your left wrist. Keep pulling those left hand to the bottom. Turn your left chest up. 3, 2, 1, slowly and come back up. Now bend your left knee, you're sitting on your left foot, flex your right toe, left elbow goes inside of your left shin, arm goes around, and you'll be grabbing your right wrist or the right hand. So pull this right hand so that your right shoulder is being rotated forward and feel your chest. 3, 2, 1, slowly, gently come up. Have two blocks by side you. If you don't have any blocks, you can also use your blocks. 3 feet apart. Heels either in one line or right heel can be slightly outside of the left heel. Left toe points the left top corner. Bring your left hip bone forward. So bring your left hip forward. Pull the right hip facing forward. Press the right toe hip firmly down. Here, moving only folding to halfway. If you have the hands of one lower back and one on your hip, so that your lower back is flattened and you're not opening up your hips, come sliding toward only the halfway. Find your core, keep pushing your right hip bone up, keep pressing your left heel down. 3, you can also challenge yourself to have your arm straight, but keep pushing your right hip bone back. Left heel firmly down for 2, for 1, use your core to slide and come up. Turn it to the left. Left toe points back to your right. Right heel is sliding back. If you have a hard time balancing, maybe your stance is too narrow, you can slightly widen your stance. Right toe points, right top corner, bring your right hip forward. Then you'll be hinging from your hips. One hand on your lower back, and one hand on your hips, and both hands will be reaching forward, but keep pushing your left hip back. Pressing your right heel down, find your core, strong core engaged for 3, posture. You'll be switching all the weight on your left foot. Find this left knee very strong, pushing back. If your mat is too thick, I find quite challenging to find balance. So step out of your mat. Press the left kick toe and then forward 400 feet, pressing down. Engage your core to lift your right leg up. Stay here for 3. 2. Keep pressing your left knee back and left hip forward. Providing this. 2. 1. Change leg. Right knee pushes back, right long is very, very strong. Lift your left knee up 90 degrees, find the balance. 3, right toe, press it down, and also the forearm of your foot. Right knee, kept back and lift your chest up. Find your hip bones to find the balance. Now, keep lifting your chest and roll your shoulders back. Keep lifting, flatten your lower back, walk your fingertips. Now your core is engaged. Come on your toes only. Keep lifting your chest forward. Come on your toes. Or maybe you can lift your toes up. Find your fingertips touch your hands by side. Hold it, your five. Keep pushing your lower leg back and down. We'll get your core. shoulder stretches and also inhalation super behind your back. But here I want you to roll through your shoulders and then base of the wrist touches together. Rather than your wrist falling apart, I want to pull them together. Roll your shoulders back. Okay? Five. Let's go. Four. Pull your shoulders back. Toes pointed. Keep lifting your chest. Five. Inhale, reach, keep pushing your hips up. Exhale. journalism, you're in trouble.